Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Mother 3. Okay, so we have climbed up the Empire Porky building through all the various floors. We finally reached the 100th. We're right outside of Porky's room, but we gotta get through this natural killer cyborg first to get in. So let's do it. Alright, so judging by this guy's appearance, you can tell he's gonna be really freakishly strong, and he really is. So, defense up, offense down are the first things you'll want to do here. Let's get to it. And this music is also worth mentioning. It's just perfect. I love this, like, battle song. It's really cool. Yeah, you kind of got to watch out for the little beat changes. It kind of, like, cuts in half there at the slow part. So you kind of have to know where those are. But otherwise, it's a pretty simple beat, and it's pretty fun to combo to. I mean, it really feels intense. I love the song. Alright, so we've gotten buffed up pretty well here, but he uses an electric shock attack, which pretty much nullifies anything we just did anyway. But thankfully, that's actually rather weak, so there's not really a whole lot to worry about here. His defense up one more time, and offense down again, and start bringing his defense down. I want to get some good combos going here. I mean, you can really, the battle is really energetic if you can. Oh, it didn't work. Come on, you can tickle that thing. Alright, so I think our defense is good enough and his offense is down pretty much all the way. Poisonous gas. Oh, he's doing all the annoying stuff first, huh? Alright, nah, that's fine. Doesn't really matter. We got Healing Omega, so we can pretty much take care of all that here. It's under recovery, I think. Yep, there it is. Alright, so let's try for defense down, and let's do the Tickle Stick, and then after this we'll pretty much just start going all out. Man, I'm having a little bit of trouble comboing for some reason. I'm usually pretty good at this song, but whatever, I guess it doesn't really matter that much. Alright, come on, tickle it! Oh man, that's so good. Alright, yeah, let's get this stupid poison off of this. It's getting really annoying. Healing Omega kind of takes a while to complete, though. It's a little bit irritating. Alright, what are you gonna do this time, buddy? Bore down and attacked. Yeah, this is what he normally does, and even through all the buffing and debuffing, that was still 97 damage, so yeah, I mean, this guy, I couldn't imagine how high his attack numbers are if we didn't debuff him first. Let's do one more defense down, and then we'll go for it. There we are. Alright, so he's down all the way on defense. Yeah, that can be a little bit hard to switch back and forth. Counter device, which is actually good. He's pretty much wasting his turn by doing that. Because Bodhi can just get rid of it. The Shield Snatcher is really good in that regard. It'd be pretty bad if he didn't have it. Ah, I forgot to switch there. Yeah, the only thing about this is the music is actually a little bit louder than the than your like combo sounds are, so it can be a little bit hard to hear if you're on time or not. See what I mean there? I mean, you can really just feel the electricity in the atmosphere here in this battle. Alright, so we need to do a little bit of healing. Might as well just go ahead and get everybody while we're at it. Just go again, I guess, here. Man, that's so slow. But yeah, I mean, this guy, as you can probably guess, has a lot of HP, so this battle might take a little while, especially, you know, I think I might actually have Lucas give us an offense up real quick, just to sort of, you know, speed things up a bit. Counter device again, alright. That's fine with me, you can do that as much as you want, buddy. Alright, so, let's see here, offense up, definitely use that. Attack, attack, and Shield Snatcher. Man, that thing is really a godsend here. This would be so much harder without it. Okay, so time for our big boost in offense here. Lucas's offense increases to 41. I mean, that's insane. I still can't believe how big of an increase we get. All right, yeah, several missiles. This one can also be a little bit of something to watch out for. I'm going to go ahead and heal us up. I mean, I'm not taking any chances here. Wow, it's so slow, man. Alright, so we're doing pretty good here. I mean, this guy isn't that much of a threat as long as you keep your HP up above, like, 100-something. Because he can do those missiles at pretty much any time, and you also have to watch out for this. It's End of the Century Beam, which just sounds awesome, and I love the animation here. Man. Yeah, so that's also a pretty hefty damage, too. We're gonna need to heal up again, so... I mean, this guy really, I mean, he's no pushover by any means. Even with our overpowered, like, offense up and defense down stuff, he's not going down easily, so... Life Up Omega is a very, very big helper here. Don't be afraid to just spend a few turns healing if you have to, you know? We're down and attacked again. Alright, let's go all out. It's getting ready to slow down here in a second again. Right now. Ah, I've never been able to carry one throughout that entire slow section. Just gonna switch up here in just a second again. See, you kind of have to memorize the song a little bit. It definitely helps. Alright, so there we go. Yeah, I mean, that was a pretty long battle. It's got a lot of health, but you should be able to figure that out just by looking at it. I mean, geez, that thing is huge. Alright, so that takes care of the Natural Killer Cyborg. Pretty dumb name, but pretty awesome boss. I mean, this is definitely one of my favorite battles in the game, if only because of the music. I mean, I love the atmosphere that it gives. Alright, so it exploded and Porky doesn't say anything, which is kind of surprising to me, but now we get to walk along here. It's funny because if you run through here, it's kind of like an optical illusion. I'm kind of going to let this music play out a little bit more, too. Like, if you run and stare in the middle, it looks like it's scrolling really fast, but you can kind of look over at the sides and, like, really smooth out the motion. I don't know, it's hard to explain, but I can see it really well. It's just, it kind of hurts my eyes a little bit, but... Alright, so we got kind of a long hallway to run through here, and, this music, I've been told, is actually the, like, theme song for the Mother 1 game on the NES. So, I mean, I'm not familiar with the game at all. I've never actually played it myself, so that's just what I've heard. But if so, that's pretty cool. We're also going to kind of get another trip down memory lane here. You can probably already see a few things here. So let's hop in the boat, and we get a nice little ride. And as we go down through here, this little hallway is pretty much... adorned on the top side there by, like, memorabilia from Earthbound, pretty much. And as you can see, first up there, there's the Runaway Fives little van there. And Tessie, of course. Gotta love Tessie. I don't know why she's just sitting there. I'd be getting out of there if I was her, but... And we got the taxi, we've got all the phones, so practically Ness's dad is right there, but whatever. And there's the Skyrunner. I think I mentioned that at some point, like, it played the Skyrunner music for something. And, of course, the pencil and eraser statues, helicopter, and Dungeon Man! Oh, I love Dungeon Man. Yeah, you can't, like, walk around or anything during this. Like, they have little, like, placards or whatever in front of them. Like, I wish you could check it and actually see what it said about it. I mean, they could put in some pretty interesting little phrases there, but... And there's the bicycle over there and the yellow submarine. And it's the phase distorter. Hey, I wonder if that's what, Pokey slash Porky used. And of course there's Pokey's little machine there at the end. And the white and black sesame seeds. Cool stuff. Yep, so that pretty much rounds out the tour. There's not really any purpose to this hallway. I mean, you don't do anything in here, but I guess it's kind of to give you a little nostalgia flashback. You know, So, yeah, whatever. It's pretty cool. I'm not complaining, definitely, so. Alright, so let's get going here. We got stuff to do. And yeah, there's kind of a neat little throwback here. For some weird reason, a pencil-shaped iron statue is blocking the path. So we can open the present here, and we get a pencil eraser. Then we use the pencil eraser. And for some weird reason, the iron pencil statue was erased. Huge throwback to Earthbound there. Alright, so yeah, let's go ahead and get in the instant revitalizing device. Heal ourselves up. Because obviously there's still much more to come. We've yet to meet Porky, so. Alright, let's let Kumatora's fever run out here. It shouldn't have too much longer on it. Yeah, see, there it is. Wow, I have pretty good timing, huh? Thunder Omega. Yeah, I probably won't really be using that. I haven't used Starstorm yet either. I don't know. I've been kind of meaning to, but I never really find an enemy that's worth using that much PP on, you know? So, eh, I don't know. Maybe we'll use it soon. Alright, so it looks like this is the top room. There's not really anywhere else to go from here. Whoa, holy crap. Storming outside, huh? The beginning of the end. The end of everything. Whoa, holy crap, where'd you come from? Jeez. Ah, so there you are, huh? Been waiting for this day. Let's be friends. I'm Porky. I'm really just this meek little boy. Please dote over me more. Please talk to me like good boys and girls. You know, just like me. No way, man. Screw you, buddy. It's not very nice, now is it? Actually, I'm not very nice either. Oh, holy crap, he exploded, what? Oh, holy crap, okay, what is going on here? Obviously that's not the real Porky, Alright, so now we are getting into a battle with Porky 01 and its cohorts, which are numbered 02, 03, and so on and so forth. There are going to be a lot of these guys showing up. I actually thought there was one more scene of dialogue because I was going to end the part here before we got into this battle, but... now that we're here, I think I am actually going to go ahead and leave it off. I hate leaving it in the middle of a battle, but this is a pretty long thing, and I want to make sure we get it all in one video, so... I didn't get to listen to this music for a little bit, so I guess don't complain too much, right? Alright, anyway, in the next part, we are going to take on all these little Porky robots here, and hopefully get to meet the real ones. So, until then, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.